Well, good morning everyone, F27 here again, and on the GSXR. It's a glorious Saturday morning, 20 to 10. Tried to get out a little bit earlier, but family life prevented that. But yeah, trying to get a ride in before the thunder, lightning and heavy rain supposed to hit us a bit later on today. Slightly different microphone configuration again today. This will be attempt number 5 at getting things right. We were always right with the last one. We still hear a bit of wind noise, but it wasn't too annoying, and it was a little bit dull, dead on the sound, I thought. So I'll turn the sensitivity settings for the mic on the camera up slightly, and applied a homemade dead cat to the microphone, which has got a considerable amount of packing around it now. If I was to put up any video that I'd done when the microphone was as it was out of the box, that's terrible. So we're getting there, we're improving. Yeah, not quite sure what's on the heavy weather. It's supposed to be coming into hit us later on today. I keep checking the Met Office app on my phone, and it keeps moving every sort of few hours. Yeah, we're just coming up to on the right hand side what used to be called Whittington Barracks, and it used to be an army infantry training. Now it's I think it's the main military medical training base. So I think you get army, Royal Navy, Royal Air Force personnel who are medically inclined to come and do their training there. They've done quite a lot of redevelopment. If I was to go in there now, probably nothing like it was when I used to frequent it. And just outside is the Staffordshire Regiment Museum, so my old regiment's museum. And over here we've got Whittington Golf Course. Nice golf course, but it's soon to be split in half at least, if not obliterated completely, by the HS2 high speed train nonsense that's being forced upon us. Shame. Here we go, Tour de France. What are you doing?
Oh,
That's it, your gasket's gone, mate. Jesus Christ. I haven't got a problem with cyclists so much. They can get to be a bit annoying when they're riding in large groups, which is a shame because it's a good sport. We have got a lot of traffic in this country and it doesn't really mix very well. I used to cycle a lot, not far off what they're doing there, but I used to do it on my own mostly, and I had a couple of bad, well, a couple of, I would say, relatively minor accidents on the road, but they were enough to put me off riding on the road, so I went to mountain biking. I used to live on the edge of Cannock Chase, so it was really handy. Get the bike out of the garage, cross the road, wallop, I was on Cannock Chase. Now you go to Cannock Chase and you can step from one side of the place to the other on the crossbars of bicycles without touching the ground. It's absolutely swarming with them. It's a shame, it spoils it for me. I sound like a right miserable bastard, and I don't like mixing with people. He's not smoking so much now, so whether he's run out of oil. So I'm just heading to CMC Bikes in Bridgetown, Cannock. I need to see if I can... I need a preload spanner for the rear shock. Can't find mine. My wife wants to have a trip out. Now the weather's getting better. Before she jumps on the back, I'll just give the rear shock an extra bit of preload. Just make sure it's all nice and safe for riding the pillion. Without the proper spanner, I'm a bit bollocksed. So I'll see if they've got one. I probably haven't. I've probably got some crappy Oxford underseat toolkit, might be about it. But we'll have a look. No, I haven't got what I wanted. Didn't think I would. So I think I'm going to have to get a preload spanner online. I know Demon Tweaks do them. Sports Bike Shop probably do them as well. I'll find one somewhere. This place in front used to be a Porsche dealership, and it's been closed for boarded up for ages, but recently it's been resurrected as a, looks like a modern classics place. We've got bikes in there as well. Might have to have a look at one of those, perhaps on the way back. So they've got original minis. There's an E-Type on the front. And the thing that I spotted the other day when I went back, a couple of weeks ago when I went back, was a Dolomite, Triumph Dolomite. One of my fond memories of a Triumph Dolomite. It was my stepdad's car. It was a cracking little motor. That was really nice and flush inside, walnut dash. Speed box with an overdrive. A little switch on the top of the gear knob and you just flicked it and it just went into overdrive. Probably a bad idea coming this way. It's Saturday morning and we're heading into Birmingham, so I think I'm gonna end it here. And so thanks for watching, drop a comment below, subscribe if you want to, if you haven't already. And I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers then. Ta-ra.